Praise the Lord, Saints. We thank you today for being here to share this broadcast with us. Today's topic was, get your life in order. The prophet Isaiah came to Jeremiah to tell him it was his time to die. But Jeremiah cried out unto the Lord. He needed to give him more time. He needed time to get his house in order. We need to get our house in order too. There's a lot of things going on in our lives that we need to take care of. There's things going on in our churches, our homes, and our families. We just need to make sure that you are focusing on the right thing and that you got your life right with the Lord. We thank you again today for sharing this broadcast with us.
Thank you. Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost this morning.
Amen.
God is good.
Amen.
First, giving God the honor and praise to my pastor and his family who was absent today. Let us read 2 Kings, please. Chapter 20, 1 through 6. We have a saved here. Second Kings chapter 20, verse 1 through 6.
Amen.
In those days, Hezekiah was sick and near death. And Isaiah the prophet, the son of And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, went to him and said to him, "Thus saith the Lord, set your house in order, for you shall die and not live." Then he turned his face toward the wall and prayed to the Lord, saying, "Remember now, O Lord, I pray how I have walked before you in truth, with a loyal heart, and have done what was good in your sight." And Hezekiah wept bitterly. And it happened before Isaiah had gone out into the middle court, that the word of the Lord came to him, saying, "Return and tell Hezekiah, the leader of my people, thus saith the Lord, the God of David, the father, I have heard your prayer and have seen your tears. Surely I will heal you on the third day. You shall go up to the house of the Lord, and I will add to your days 15 more years. I will deliver you in this city from the hand of the king of Assyria, and I will defend this city for my own sake and for the sake of my servant David." May God add a blessing to his written word.
Amen.
Let us pray, please. Heavenly Father, I come to you this morning, dear God. Giving it all to you. Oh God, I ask you right now, dear God, just to remove me from this pulpit this morning, dear God. Dear God, you step in. You speak through me, oh God. Dear God, you speak that I may lift you up, dear God, that I may glorify your holy name this morning, dear God.
Yes.
Dear God, we ask you, Father, just to bless us, dear God, as we stand this morning, dear God, giving you the worship and the glory, dear God, that you deserve.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 God gave me a word this morning. He told me that this topic should be, your time is running out.
All right.
Amen.
Before I left home this morning, there was a commercial on TV. In fact, some spiritual commercial that we've seen, my wife and I, that was the same title. And it kind of amazed me. I'm like, God is talking to someone. The same title. Your time is running out. And Hezekiah, the prophet, and I'm quite sure that Hezekiah, the prophet, was a faithful prophet. The king Hezekiah was, they say, was one of the faithful kings that it was. And when I read it, it said that, get your house in order. And I want you to know this morning that when it said, get your house in order, thanks for bargaining, please. So get your house in order. It said that, I don't mean go out here to Belts and buy you some new bed sheets or a new dressers or pillowcases. It said, get your house in order.
Amen.
What it's saying to me that if something is in your house, it might be your son, or it might be your daughter.
Right.
It said that, get your house in order. And you know, most of us have that mentality that God is saying, clean your house up, it might be dirty. But this is what God is saying, a spiritual house. If you're not coming to the means of grace, you might miss Sunday school, you might miss Bible class, you might have a sinful desire that's not of God in your house. So God was telling Hezekiah, get your house in order. So now I'm quite sure God was reflecting to Hezekiah to tell the people of the world, get your house in order. And he knew that many of us has been pretending that we're Christians for years and years. We come to church and we pray and we fellowship and, you know, we go to meetings. But God has said, get your house in order. And he's saying that if anything that you put it before me this morning, you must let it go. Get your house in order. He said, new home, get your house in order. He said, White Hill, get your house in order. Gold Hill, Liberty Hill, whatever hill it might be, get your house in order. And he came to Hezekiah and he sent a message to Hezekiah and he told Hezekiah, he said, Hezekiah, I know that you've been faithful. You've visited the sick. You pay your tithes. But he's saying, Hezekiah, I know you might be a young man. Brother Jay, you might be a young man. Brother Dunlap, you might be a young man, but get your house in order. He said, I don't care how old you are, how young you are, and how much your health test come out and said you're in good health. He said, get your house in order. He said, Hezekiah, I know you think you're all that, but get your house in order. He said, Hezekiah, you're going to die one day. New home. You're going to die one day. Get your house in order. And he's telling Hezekiah that, Hezekiah, I know you're one of my faithful servants. You're faithful. You're here every Sunday. You're here on Tuesday. You're here on Wednesday nights. But Hezekiah, you're going to die one day. And so Hezekiah, he went to the Lord and said, Lord, don't you remember that I'm one of your faithful servants, that I do everything that you asked me to do, that I pray for my family, that you're a good wife, you're a good husband. But God said, I know that, Hezekiah. You see, sometimes we go to God and we want to ask God questions. See, God knew this, but he wanted to remind Hezekiah that, Hezekiah, I know that you're a faithful servant, but get your house in order. He said, Hezekiah, I don't care what you got, what kind of home you got, how many cars that you got.
Amen.
You're going to die one day.
Amen.
So when Hezekiah went to the Lord, he said, Lord, don't you remember that when I came out to New Home Church and it was raining and it was snowing and it was cold and I was the only one there. He said, Hezekiah, I know that. But get your house in order. You're going to die one day.
Amen.
So God sometimes he'll test us, you know, just to see what side we're on. And Hezekiah, he went to the Lord and he questioned the Lord. And sometimes we do the same thing to as Christians.
Amen.
We want to test the Lord.
Amen.
Just to see. And God said, Hezekiah, I know that you've done all this right here.
Yes.
He said, but I'm going to give you 15 more years. He sent someone to tell Hezekiah before he got to the middle court. He said, go and tell my servant Hezekiah that I'm going to grant him 15 more years on his lifespan. And I want to ask you this morning. If God came to you this morning in New Hope and told you that you were going to die right now. Now, we know we're all going to die because a man born of a woman's womb have a short time upon the land. We know that much.
Amen.
But if God would send someone to tell you that, Sister Jenny, you're going to die today, Sister Pam said, you're going to die today. If God would tell you that this morning, how would you react? Would you still be faithful? Would you get bent out of shape? You know that you're going to die one day. But Hezekiah was the king, the prophet. He was somebody.
Right.
And God know that we all in here have titles on our name. You might be a doctor, a lawyer, a teacher. So it really doesn't matter who you are, that you're going to die one day. So when Hezekiah, when God sent the messenger to tell Hezekiah that you're going to die, and I can just imagine how Hezekiah felt. Lord, me? Me, your faithful servant? But it just goes to show you that sometimes God will tell us. So God added 15 more years on his lifespan. And he said that in this time that Hezekiah was the king, he said there would become famines upon the land, earthquakes, pestilence upon the land. And we as Christians right now, we have witnessed this right here. It wasn't long ago that we had a tremor of an earthquake in Charlotte, North Carolina, and Lowell and Gaston in South Carolina. But sometimes God has to come to us and shake us up.
Amen.
We come in God's house every Sunday, looking good, smelling good. But are you faithful? Are you coming to church to please the preacher? Are you coming to church to please your mother or your father? Are you coming to please God?
Amen.
You see, God knew your heart.
Yes.
And see, God knew Hezekiah's heart.
Yes.
But he wanted to see, was Hezekiah still on his side?
Yes.
Are you still on the Lord's side?
Amen.
Are you going to run to the end? Are you just going to run halfway and throw the towel in?
All right.
You see, Hezekiah was a faithful man. You might be faithful this morning, but are you saved? Are your heart in the right place? Do you love your enemies? Do you love those who spitefully use you? The ones who lie on you? The ones that are jealous of you because you look like you look? Or drive what you drive? What kind of soldier are you? You see, time is running out. We have no time to come in God's house and sit back and relax and kick back. We have neighbors out in the world that's going astray. Kids are hungry.
Amen.
Fathers against sons. Mothers against mothers. We have pedophiles. We have drug addicts. Your time is running out. And I know some things you don't want to get us moved. We have men marrying men. Women marrying women. But let me tell you, Christians, your time is running out. God said, get your house in order. Your time is not long. Get in order. Hezekiah, the faithful king. And you know, back in that time, there were idols, where idol worship. We come to church on Sunday. We say, praise the Lord. Glory be to his name. But who are you really worshiping on the days of the week? Do you worship that job? Do you worship that car that you just bought? Do you worship the big house with the white fence around? But then you worship your child because he is so good at sports and she is the best of the best. God said, get your house in order. Why are we coming to church? Do we come to praise God or do we come to lift man? There's no time to sit back and let Satan contaminate our church.
Amen. 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 Amen.
yes, contaminated your home. Because most of us go home with no peace. There's no happiness, there's no joy. You go to the job, you hear all that mess from Monday to Friday. Satan is in the mix of all this right here. God is telling Hezekiah, get your house in order. But we have come to be content with whatever the devil give us. Whatever the devil say, we say, okay, thank you. But when God said, I want you to go over there and feed the hungry, what do we say? Lord, my gas head is low. I don't have much gas to go over there. Your time is running out. Get your house in order, church. You're going to die one day. I don't care how many times you go to the doctor with you. Get good reports, visit. You say, I'm healthy, you know. No blood pressure, no arthritis, no bad heart. But God said, you're going to die one day. Get it in order. He didn't want you to come in here and be quiet. He wants you to come in with praise and worship. Glorify him. We can go to a ball game, you know, and have more fun than we can in church. Amen. Amen. Because no one want to say anything. When it comes to God, we keep quiet on God. We lay down on God. We close our mouth on God. Nobody want to praise the Lord anymore. But if your favorite team is playing this morning, get them. Run them down. Nobody want to run the devil down this morning.
All right.
Who want to tackle the devil this morning? Who want to cast him out of you this morning? Who want to crush his head this morning? Who want to spit in his face this morning? Your time is running out. There's no time to play.
That's right.
We got to get serious about God.
Amen.
And Hezekiah knew there were idols, you know. And after Hezekiah was healed by God, you see, Hezekiah forgot. The Babylonians who came and asked Hezekiah about his riches. Hezekiah started boasting. I got this. I got that. But he never gave God any things. I know you went to school and you got a degree in sociology, psychology. But how many times have you given God the glory for that house that God gave you? How many times have you given God the praise for that car that you drive, that new suit that you wear, that new dress that you wear this morning? No one gives God the glory and the honor. Seems like the devil has contaminated your mouth. No one seems to have love in this. It breaks my heart. You want peace? You want peace in your home? Give God some glory.
Yeah.
Praise him on the good times.
Yeah.
Praise him on the bad times.
Yeah.
Because there will be bad times in your life. I don't care how you're doing right now. You might be doing good. Everything is going smooth in your life. But there will be some bad times in your life too. Those that have lost loved ones, still praise God. Give God the honor and the glory. We can't give God all that he deserves. Because he's God. Love your enemies. Pray for them. Hezekiah. Can you imagine how you felt when God said, I'm going to give you 15 more years. And you know, most of us in here, young ladies are senior ladies. of an age, maybe in his 70s or maybe 80s. And if God would come and tell you this morning that I want to grant you 25 more years to your life, wouldn't that be a blessing this morning? You see, we don't know the time or the day that we're going to leave here. We do know one thing. Our time is running out. Look at your watch. It never said the same. You might have said it this morning for 7:30. Now, it's 5 minutes past 12. Your time is running out. Time don't stand still for you. We're not here to judge anyone. Can't no one in here judge someone. We don't have a right. The lady that had committed adultery. And God said, if there's anyone among you have not sinned, what did he say? Cast the first stone. Those that had picked up the stones and to drop them back on the ground. Can anyone in here this morning say they can honestly cast the stone this morning? Anyone. But we are so judgmental. Oh, you know, she done this right here. He done that. Look at yourself. Amen. What have you done? Have you forgave your brother? Because we all are weak to sin. I don't care how we live, we all will sin at times or not. But we do know we can go to God in prayer. Amen. So drop those stones this morning. Drop them. Only God can judge. Hezekiah had forgotten. New Home, have you forgotten this morning what God has done for you? Have you forgotten what God is doing for you? Amen. Right now.
Amen.
If you want to look at the real picture, none of us are worthy.
Amen.
We're not worthy of God's blessing. We know that he died on the cross for our sins. But are we really worthy? Ask yourself, am I worthy? You know yourself better than anyone else. You know what you've done in your life. You know what you're still doing in your life. But are you really worthy of God's blessing this morning? Are you worthy to be saved? I'm your son. Oh, that's my daughter. But God can see that. Only God sees the heart from the inner part. We judge you for what we see on the outer part, which we don't have right to. We have nowhere to put you. Only God. Your time is running out, new one. This year right here has been pretty much a hectic year for some of you. Harsh times. Some of you lost your jobs. Some have lost their homes. Repossessed cars. Your account is made too low. Some have lost loved ones this year. Your time is running out. Tell your friends, tell your neighbors, that God lives. If you need someone to lean on, the everlasting God. The one that went down to the well and told the lady that she had five husbands. And the one that she have now is not hers.
Right.
The same God that went down to the river and The blind man couldn't see. And he tied him in the eye with mud, and he opened his eyes and he seen. The lame man that couldn't walk, that God healed him. And he went leaping and jumping and praising God.
Yeah.
The same God that taught the lady with the issue of blood, and she had him 12 long years. And he healed her. And she went praising and worshiping God. The same God that took you out of the clubs 15 years ago. The same God that took you off the streets 20 years ago. The same God that took you out of the gambling house. The same God is telling you the time is running out. The same God is telling you the one that has a stone in your hand to drop it. The same God that's blessing you this morning to come out here and worship him and praise him and lift his name up and glorify him. You see, many of us have got to the point we think that we've got to glorify man. He's blessed just like you and me. When God created man, he gave breath to just dirt. We were dirty. Created man, that man would be a living being. Your time is running out. God is saying, get your house in order. Forget about things of the world. This is not our home. We're just traveling through. Do you want to go to a better place? Do you think this is right here what you're supposed, where you're supposed to be? Right here on earth, you know, going through turmoil, gossip, hard times, pain, sickness, death. God has something better for you. But you got to trust it. You got to depend only on God. Your time is running out. You see, no matter how many times you come to church and hear the word of God, there's going to always be someone that's not going to get it.
Amen.
There's going to be someone that's not going to get it. Even when Noah was building the ark, and they said, that old preacher must be a crazy old preacher. It's not going to rain 40 days and 40 nights. But when God sealed the ark up, and the rain came, the ark started to move, and the people that are out there gambling and whole money, the one that started trouble, just to get us a mess, it was sealed up.
Amen.
They couldn't get on board. We have those same people today in churches and in the world. They don't believe nothing. God is saved. Get your house in order. Time is running out. Get yourself straight first. You go to God and repent. You talk to God. Mother got hurt. You go to God for yourself. Can't no one go to God but you. Now I can go on behalf of you for God. I can go and pray for you. But you got to go for yourself. Ask God to take whatever that's in your life that's not pleasing in God. Remove it. Because you don't know tomorrow might be your last day. Brother James. Brother John. Time is running out. Sister Kate. Time is running out. When you get out of bed in the morning and your step getting a little short and your eyes getting a little dim, And some things you have on your mind that you forget. And you can't understand, why did I forget this right here? You say, it was right on my tongue, but I forgot it.
Yeah.
Time's running out. When you can't tell one season from another season,
all right.
Time's running out.
Yes,
when you see blooms on a tree in November,
yes, sir.
Time's running out.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. One day is 32, next day is 75.
Yeah.
It should be cold right now. I mean cold. Think about it. Time is running out. So God is saying, get your house in order. You're going to die. Church, get your house in order. Time is running out.
Wow, that was an awesome service. We pray that you were blessed by that. Why don't you come and join us here at New Home, where you can get these teachings for yourself. Remember, we're praying for you, and we hope that you'll be blessed.